You may have seen this design in shops or online, or you may even own something like this yourself. But have you ever wondered how they're made? In this video, I'm going to show you what materials I use and the process I undertook to make it. Let's get started. I'm going to be using this silver D-band wire, which is 6mm wide and 2mm thick. As well as a silver BELCHER ROLO chain necklace. And some 1mm silver round wire. The first thing we're going to do is measure out 6.5cm along the D-band wire and make a mark using a scriber. We then move the mark we made back to zero and mark another 6.5cm. We then cut through the marking we made in the metal and remove the excess metal. Now my blade got stuck at this point, but the metal was thin enough for me to bend it, and after a few twists it split into two. We then tidy up the edges as best we can. The straighter the edges are will make soldering them together a lot easier. I can now begin to shape the wire into a ring shape. It doesn't have to be perfect since we'll shape it later. This metal came pre-annealed, so it's relatively easy to shape it with my hands to start off, but later I use a pair of round pliers to finish the job. You want to get the edges as close as you can and leaving as little space as possible. With that done, you can now solder the first ring together. Allow it to cool and then place it on a ring mandrel and hit it with a wooden mallet. This will give the ring its circular form. Then we remove any marks that were made with the file. The second ring is shaped the same way, but we're not going to solder it. Instead, we re-anneal it until it goes into a pinkish colour. This softens the metal so you can shape it with a mandrel without having to solder it together. I then tidy up the insides of the ring using a Dremel. Before placing the already soldered ring inside the slot of the open ring, I then close the ring up and solder the gap together. I then take the 1mm round wire and create a single loop. And cut it in half. These half loops are then soldered onto the ring. Then we take the necklace and hold the link section in one hand, while the other runs along to find the opposite end, so we have two equal lengths. We then cut the link with some cutters so we have one long chain. This will give us two ends, and we cut the last link from both ends. Then use a pair of tweezers to open up these links so the gap is big enough to fit around the 1mm half loop we soldered to the ring. And this is the rough look of the finished result. You can then solder the end links of the necklace to the loops. Notice the flame is on a low setting, as the item is extremely thin and will melt under too much temperature. With all the connections made, we can move on to remove any scratches on the ring. I use a silver pin wheel to remove any scratches from the inside of the ring. And a buff stick to remove any finer scratches later on. I then use a bristle polishing wheel with triple polishing compound. For a final polish using rouge. After both rings are polished, this is the finished result. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe. And if there's something you want me to make, comment it down below. And I'll see you next time.